The College Basketball Experience Bombs Down Under, episode 4, Tuesday, February 20th and Wednesday, February 21st on the Sports Gambling Podcast Network, is brought to you by Game Time, your home for the lowest priced last minute tickets. Download the Game Time app today and use that promo code SGPN to get $20 off. We're also brought to you by Underdog Fantasy. Yes, play Underdogs, pick them for a chance to win 100 times the amount of money you enter. Promo code TCE SGPN at underdogfantasy.com for a 100% deposit match. We're also brought to you by Hall of Fame Bets. Yes, the sports betting research platform for parlays, player props, and game lines. Download the Hall of Fame Bets app or visit HOFBets.com. Use that promo code SGPN and get 50% off your first month and start making smarter bets today, people. And remember, as always, folks, too, let it ride.
Hey, this is John Sally, and you're listening to SGPN. Let it ride.
Experience Bombs Down Under for for Tuesday, February 20th and Wednesday, February 21st. A lot has been happening in the college basketball world as the road to what it is, it's in Scottsdale or Phoenix this year, the national championship, as we get, as we load up for March Madness. We have coaches calling out his own team, saying this is the worst experience of his life. We got little dust ups in the handshake in line after a nice Southland basketball game. We got a loaded slate. So what else do you want, folks? If you're wondering who the hell you're listening to, my name is Colby Swinging Danter Base Dan, AKA Pick Dundee. That's not a pick. This is a pick.
He was raised in the land down under, where a man thinks on his feet, speaks with his fists, and lives by his wits.
When Dundee happened, he was a superstar.
I smoke and I drink and I don't have stress and I'm healthy.
Shout out to the chat. You can watch this youtube.com/thecollegeexperience. Rolex Dad. Whew. Says, I missed the hell out of this show.
Yes.
Says, keep up the great work, gents. Rolex wearing. It's a flip, kid flip move right there.
Kid having.
What's that?
Said kid having, kid Rolex having, wearing.
Yeah. Did he say something about alligator shoes or something?
So yeah, crocodile like wearing. Somewhere.
Yeah.
Limousine riding. Like,
Yeah. There's all that shit, and yeah. I mean, Ric Flair was way ahead of his time. He, what did he say? I spend more money on spilt liquor than you make in a year. So does this guy right here, the host of the Bottom Line Bombs podcast. Which, what are you doing, folks? You're not subscribed to this. You're missing out. It's a year-round show. Whatever the sport is, all right, yep, going on at the time. You better believe he's gonna have a mint julep special on the Kentucky Derby. You know, just whatever the sport. I'm sure he was talking a ton of Daytona as they those pussies wouldn't play on Sunday because of a they call him the man in the box, and I forget all of his other fucking nicknames. Give it up for CJ Sullivan. How you doing, brother?
Yeah. Also the back detective. No. What's up there, Daddy? No. Dundee, as you got some kids. I had a little Daytona 500, hit a top five thanks to that huge crash right before the ending. I like when everyone wrecks and then my guys come in from the back and sneak in there and get ourselves into money.
Robin's racing.
But what a weekend, baby. What a weekend of college hoop. And then I promise you listeners this. Of course, we will keep up the great work. We can't do anything but that. And we will put in more effort than the NBA All-Stars did for the NBA All-Stars. That's
for sure. Adam Silver giving the war. It's like, who? Good game. You want this award?
Right. Are you proud of this? I'm not saying you got to play game seven type defense, but can you step in front of somebody? I mean, you got to put down cones if you're going to do that shit, at least something. My God.
But I could get injured. See, we've reached this point, CJ.
Yeah, what do you think? They're playing football? What do you mean you're going to get injured? You're fucking shooting jumpers. You're playing carnival games out there.
We've reached this point in society where it's like before we were so far on the other end of the spectrum where, you know, the overreaction is you just go so far the other way.
Right.
It's everywhere. It's whether it's the transfer portal, whether even the fucking coaches that are leaving, like Chip Kelly's just like, I'm gonna be an offensive coordinator at Ohio State.
I don't want to. I don't want to recruit. I don't want to do anything with draw up shit.
Everyone's a pussy.
You're right. Am I allowed
to say that? Yeah. It's just 100% of society.
Scott G is right. This show is great. Comedy, sports, life, and more. That's what we're giving you. We're giving you life and more, and we're telling you what's wrong with society. And some winners on the way.
Life. We can talk about life. I mean, I feel like society, let your kids play sports. Football. Yes. I am walking, talking, living proof of, a guy that played football at the youngest levels. All right. Play fucking football, play basketball, play baseball, play all these sports. So we can talk about these later.
Play defense.
Yes. You play Herm Edwards. I got this clip somewhere on here.
I don't get they're in cone, but they're counting down 7-6-5.
Hello? You play to win the game. You don't play to just play it.
I mean, dude, I couldn't watch any of that shit. I tried.
I tried five minutes. I was like, good night, nurse, dude. This is insane. It was just mindless. It was hilarious.
Yeah. Yeah, it's just so bad. It's so fucking bad. Now, let's call out, speaking of...
defense in the NBA All-Star game, and then there's what apparently St. John's did versus Seton Hall defense-wise.
Look, I like Rick Pitino. I liked betting on his teams over the course of my lifetime. Mm-hmm. But he is a part of the problem, too. And I know he's old school generation.
Yeah.
But... let me tell you about old school generation. Their legendary coaches have egos through the fucking moon. All right. I remember Coach K. Remember Coach K when COVID was happening? He knew that Duke team wasn't good. I think cancel the whole tournament. Cancel everything. Yeah. Let's get it going. I guarantee you, if he was a one seed, mm-hmm. he'd be like, no, we need to play the tournament. We need to play the tournament.
He's all for it. He's all for sports unifying our nation and bringing people together during these tough times.
So Rick Pitino, they lose. They blow a 20-point lead against Seton Hall. And it wasn't at the Garden, and it wasn't in Queens. It was in like Brooklyn or something. I forget where. It was maybe where the Nets play. But he then basically throws his whole team under the bus after...
Called them all weak and said it was the most unenjoyable experience of his lifetime.
Oh, man. I love that. If that's the most unenjoyable experience of your lifetime.
That's the most unenjoyable experience of his lifetime. The man who left Louisville, fucking his mistress on the floor of an Italian restaurant, and then making his assistant coach marry her.
In 40 seconds. Yeah.
Yeah. He forces assistant coach to marry her to get her out of his hair. Like, hey, you have to take one for the team here, buddy. But I'm married. Don't worry, I took care of that too. You're divorced now.
They can't put you on the stand if you get married. Right? So let me tell you this right now. You're getting married. You may hate each other, but you're getting married.
Trust me, she's a good lay. You're gonna love it. I roped you off a section at the restaurant, but the loss to Seton Hall was the most unenjoyable experience of his lifetime. He called them out by names and just said that none of them can move laterally. What I love is they're all his guys.
Well, that's the thing. He did a tweet this offseason saying like we have worked the transfer portal to perfection. Yeah. We've brought in enough talent on this team. And then 6 months later, they're the fucking worst pieces of shit.
Yeah.
They're absolute worst. They don't believe to breathe the same fucking air I breathe. All right. And look, we're terrible. This has been the most frustrating time of our life. But dude, let's call a spade a spade here. What happened? If I had to guess, I know St. John's NIL collector is not very good. If any at all, guess what? You're not at Kentucky where you throw bags of cash underneath the table,
right?
You're not at Louisville where you throw bags of cash and prostitutes under the table. All right. Welcome to life, you know, without an NIL collective. And the game has changed a little bit. You can't just have a bag, man. Everybody can pay.
Speaking of which, I like when he just threw St. John's facilities under the bus too for no reason. No one asked him that. He asked his own question.
They weren't even playing in Queens that day.
Right. And no one, he asked himself his own question. Are our facilities shit? Yeah, they are. But that had nothing to do with our defense. What? No, we didn't ask you that. What are you talking about? We're physically weak and we're slow laterally. Also, Jesus.
You know what that is, though, in a way, is I'm scolding him. I'm saying, man, what a piece of shit for throwing these players. Like, have some fucking accountability. But at the same time, it's also fucking genius because I do think the NIL collective will go way up and they're going to throw money into their into their facilities. So in a way, it might be genius long term, even though he'll probably be dead in the next 5 years. But I mean, yeah, no reporter says one thing about the facilities. Are our facilities terrible? Oh, they're absolutely fucking terrible.
They sure are, but don't blame them. No one's blaming them. What are you talking about? You're the only one blaming everything. He even gave Georgetown some fucking strays because he's like, it's like, I don't even think we can beat Georgetown. I mean, who knows? We can lose to Georgetown next game. Who gives a shit?
Yeah, I mean, dude, it's like, what are you? You're not even, you could definitely, you've lost like 6 out of 7. Yeah, you could lose the Georgetown. Right.
But meaning we can lose to anybody. Here? We're fucking terrible. Even Georgetown can beat us, and they're garbage. All right, Rick.
Ed Cooley saying, what the fuck? Ed Cooley,
yeah, Cooley's got his Cooley's got his brandy at that fucking, at the White Eagle bar. And he's like, what the? Oh, keep me out of this, Rick.
Ed Cooley got ridiculed the other day. Maybe in the past 2 weeks, about at Georgetown, some fans are giving him shit.
Yeah, and he said he made more money than them or whatever.
Yeah, he said, I'm rich, motherfucker. You're not.
He's like, it's just kids. They like joking around. I like messing around with them, you know.
I kind of stand by his approach there. I stand by his approach. Yeah.
Listen, when college kids are heckling you, they deserve anything. No holds barred. Yes. Although I don't know, obviously they're going to respond, getting called out by name and being called pieces of shit by Pitino. But I mean, it seemed a bit over the top.
Yeah, definitely. Yesterday in Texas A&M Commerce Incarnate Word, which I know you were watching, right? Oh, yeah.
I love Incarnate Word.
Yeah. Those Redbirds, really, the Cardinals, those Redbirds, little dust up after. Well, first off, I had money on Incarnate Word. They lost a bunch of bitches. And then a little dust up in the line. I wish I could play the clip, but I'll get sued.
What happened?
You get eyes on this? Yeah, you can't play. The ESPN's putting this thing out. You can't play it. They'll come for me.
Oh, God forbid. They can play the fucking J.J. Redick hot take from 50 different angles. And goddamn Austin Rivers coming in. They can manufacture own news and flood your feed with it. But God forbid someone shares an actual interesting video.
Oh, this is the best thing to happen to Southland basketball. It's funny. Southland tweeted out this whole apology. So sorry for everyone. I'm like, what are you fucking? This is great. I never had any interest in really. I mean, I did have interest specifically in that game because of the I bet. But now a possible matchup in the Southland tournament. You have my attention. You have my attention. This is what you do. You start a fight like this. If I was the commission, any of these smaller leagues, I would not reprimand them at all. I would say, guys, let's. Pick it up a little bit. This is newsworthy. Get on here. No one else is tuning into Incarnate Word Hoops. Do it again.
Now, where is Incarnate Word? San Antonio.
San Antonio, Texas. You been down
what
there?
Do you
San
think?
Antonio?
Yeah, I've been to San Antonio. Very dull town. Have you ever? What do you think of this handshake line? I think that's part of the problem.
It's almost like the Michigan State thing, the locker, you know, the tunnel, the same tunnel.
Yeah, yeah. I mean, what is this, a hockey playoff series or shit? We got to shake hands. Way to go. Good, gentlemen. Get the fuck out of here. Separate lockers.
I kind of like it because I want to see fights.
Yeah, I mean, it is good. It maybe keeps them accountable.
I was part of a handshake fight when I was like 13 or 14 where the leading scorer on the opposing team that we beat used his water bottle to squirt one of our players in the face. Right. Ooh. While they're shaking hands.
Yeah.
And then we got in a big fight and it was fantastic. But so I'm pro anything that will make the sport better. And what these idiots don't realize is that a fight makes the sport better. You know, we were talking NBA at the beginning of this.
And basketball fights are just 95% of people holding each other back.
Yeah. Yeah.
And it's just them running around. All hold me backs, breaking out the hold me backs. This is all this was. And nothing really ever happens. Let them go. I'd say let them burn themselves out for a while. You know, let this fight happen. Then they probably won't fight again. The old handshake fight water bottle. When you're little, you would spit on the palm. That was an old trick.
Ooh.
I mean, you're taking your own blast, but you get to give them some of that.
It depends the sport too. If it's soccer, you do the old orange peel. How do you squeeze that? You just hit him in the face with that, you know? Just
get right in the eyeball. The old orange peel.
Oh, you got to do the old orange peel. Nothing like an orange peel to the dome. All right. Well, shit. Let's start picking winners. By the way, Georgetown.
All right.
Catching 10.
See, I mean,
in the nation's capital.
Obviously, when I first heard the comments, I go, well, I'm playing St. John's no matter what. But 10, that's a cake. That's a Pitino caked in line there. That's a lot of fucking points.
That is. That's a lot.
For a team that is, in their coach's words, atrocious on defense.
Yeah, I'm definitely thinking about taking the 10. Tonight, before we get into tomorrow's action, this Villanova line keeps going up. What am I missing here?
I don't understand it. When I saw 6.5, I grabbed it.
7.5 I'm seeing right now.
Yeah, I'd still take 7.5. I don't understand this line at all. I think Butler's done until maybe the tournament. They had their shot versus Marquette at home.
Oh, you're taking Nova, saying.
I'm taking Nova. I know you like Butler, but I think Butler's done with. Obviously they're going to have probably a bounce back at the Creighton, just trash them. But I don't like Butler. I only like Butler at home, and they had this back-to-back disappointing game.
Look, that's my point. Is like normally Hinkle and Butler, even in down years, is a tough place. This year, Butler's won at Marquette, right?
Yeah,
they kept it within 9 at UConn. They won at Georgetown. Mm-hmm. They won at Creighton by 1. They've been better on the road. Now they did get blasted at Xavier by 14. And at St. John's by 16,
Villanova is the most untrustworthy, quote unquote, good team in the history of the country. Goddamn country. I hate laying points with Villanova.
Dude, if you're Butler and you're coming to Philadelphia, you need to call up Fran Dumfrey, call up Penn.
Yeah.
All those Philly teams were beating the shit out of Villanova. What were they doing right? I'm with you. I'm with you. I'm on the Bulldogs.
I know you're on the Bulldogs. I think the Butler's a defeated team right now.
I will say this, bit terrified the line's going up. If anything, I thought it was going to be going down.
Mm-hmm. All right, Logan Square.
Yeah.
Listen, I know. I got some Kerry Kittle's notes. Jay Lawson.
Remember when I go back to the
Steve Lapis rat days.
You remember when Kerry Kittles got suspended and had to do like a public apology
for calling cards
for Wasn't a fucking calling like card? The NCAA suspended this kid for calling his fucking mom and his girlfriend. Apparently those are the two.
Yeah.
Right. With someone else's phone card, and he got his half. Didn't he get suspended like half the year? I feel like it was half the year.
It was insane. They were almost good games.
The NCAA deserves all the everything coming. After shit like that.
I like the under. I tell you what, I think we can both agree. I like the under in that game. I saw the total like at 140, which is pretty insane.
Yeah, I'm seeing 140 right now. There's 139.5 out there too.
I like it. Out of either side, my favorite side of that game is the under.
Let's fucking go. Iowa is at Michigan State. Iowa's off a huge overtime win against the other staples in the Big Ten, Wisconsin. Michigan State 13-2 at home, but one of those losses is to JMU. They're vulnerable. I'm on Michigan State. I think Izzo always right around this time of year. Right around this time of year, you can really see that tide turn.
I'm with Sparty there too. I got a little yapper here, which I kind of like.
It's easy to see a tide turn.
What do you got? What do you got? What yapper? What yapper are you working with?
And this is what a team last show I said I did not like, and I was correct as they did not cover. They got blown out. Not blown out, but it lost. But West Virginia catching 2.5 now. It opened up at 3.5. I think they went out right over Central Florida at home tonight at in Morgantown, plus 125 money line. I'll grab that as well.
I've gotten burned on them so much, but I did pick them, but I'll play your music.
Morgantown, you'll always be home sweet home to me. Good old Morgantown. Morgantown WP.
Look, I think you're right. I think you're going to hit on this, but I just wonder when they quit. You want to talk about a year. You want to talk about a year. West Virginia had the Huggins thing where he calls out the great Xavier fan base.
Yeah, what he calls.
Then he thought he was at Ohio when he was in Pittsburgh, completely shit hammered with the flat tire because he went over one of the spike strips.
Trash bag full of empties in the back seat.
And then they fire him, but then he leaves. I agree. I'm going to leave. All right. But then he's not clearing out his office. He goes into work. You know, it's like, wait a second, what's going on here? Then he recommends a different coach than the one they go with. And you know, then players leaving left and right. Jose Perez, who ends up at Arizona State. You had the Trey Mitchell situation. It was just crazy. It was chaos. Joe Toussaint goes to Texas Tech, and it's just been a crazy offseason. He shows up to a game. He's on the other side of the fucking we're supporting the other team's colors. You know what I mean? So then you have and then you had the player situation where they didn't get the waivers to they got Raekwon Battle and a few other players waivers super late, like mid December. So they were already shitty way before that. You have a lot of those players committed thinking they were going to play for Huggins. So you just have the situation where you're like, man, that's a lot to endure for 1 year for one program. I do wonder about when they're going to quit or if they're going to quit, but I am taking West Virginia. What are you doing here? I mean, you're locking this. This is what
I'm locked in. I like West Virginia. It's just, both teams are, struggling right now. They've gone 1-4 in our past five games. But I think this is the get right spot for West Virginia coming in at home against Central Florida, who, they're just inconsistent. I don't trust their offense at all.
Shout out to Colt. He says, I'm trying to look busy at work so I can watch this live. Love it.
West Virginia will be at full strength. So I don't know. I like them catching points.
Hopefully you're not a crossing guard, Colt. All right. just trying to look busy. I'll tell you, I got some plays that you might want to jump on here. For his dogs go, it seems to be a trendy dog, but UConn's losing in Omaha.
They're losing in Omaha. I mean, this is the
Warren. There is no
way. This is the Warren Buffett special. Creighton.
There is no way. You know, they think they're going to walk up into Omaha for this road trip. Half the team doesn't even know where the fuck Omaha is. All right. They're going to land there. They're going to walk into this Blue Jay Stadium. This place is going to be rocking. I've talked to coaches in the past, and they always say this is one of the hardest places to win in college basketball. I think they proved that correct because I think the Blue Jays money line sprinkle against UConn. You already bet this, I take it.
Yeah, I'm on Creighton here. It just seems so. The only downside is two downsides. One, UConn looks like the best team in the history of college basketball. Number two, it just seems like the obvious upset letdown after that blowout versus Marquette and Hartford coming in. Creighton also looking great. I mean, that was an impressive massacre against Butler. Yeah. And, you know, they look great. I mean, I see them. How many teams do you think the Big East are sending in there?
Well, Butler Nova is kind of a playoff game tonight.
Yeah.
You know, I feel like the loser. Now, Butler could probably still get in. Nova needs, they're on the outside right now. But obviously, what? Creighton, Marquette.
These are Final Four teams. They can do like that 85 year when they had three of the four Final Four teams, it seems like.
We'll see if they put St. John's in just because of Rick Pitino's name.
I'm putting him in. If he's going to keep going nuclear, fuck it, throw him in there. Come on. Or at least have him commentate on the other teams and just call out everybody for being weak.
So wait, that's three. Xavier, I think, is on the outside. That's what's crazy is actually like Xavier right now, Xavier, St. John's, and Nova probably on the outside.
Yeah.
Providence is in, I think, if it started today, but I know they still have some work to do. But I think they're in if it started today. Georgetown, way out. DePaul, way out. And that's everybody, right? Am I forgetting somebody? I might be forgetting somebody.
Providence,
not as many as Seton Hall. Seton Hall's
Hall.
Yeah, Seton
Hall. Yeah, the Hall's going to do some damage in the Big East tournament. They always do.
Yeah. Jared Bush saying fade UConn at your own peril, though. We'll find out. We'll find out, buddy. Some other live dogs.
Now, there's some huge numbers in some games that dogs that we like usually. I'm looking at Arkansas getting 11. I'm looking at Mizzou getting 12 at home.
Oh, I like that Mizzou angle, but hold on. You want to talk a little crazy? You know, Wyoming, shout out to Rolex Dad. He's on this. And it's at 14.5 now, I'm seeing. Wyoming's won 7 straight against Nevada.
Wow. I like this already.
That includes Reno. That includes Laramie. That includes the tournament in Las Vegas. UNLV just took on Nevada, you know, rivalry game, Fremont Cannon. I think Nevada has the potential to blow out anyway. They're a good team. This is like Steve Alford's best team probably since his New Mexico days. But I just think it's a sleepy spot. You just beat your rivals. You just came back to beat your rivals. You come back home, you're taking on a 500, just barely above 500 Wyoming team. I don't think you're thinking, we get to play Wyoming again. No. And Jeff Linder's bunch is always chippy, especially against Nevada. So I'm going to take the 14.5, maybe.
A little sprinkle. I mean, it's always craziness with Wyoming. Why not? I mean, I'll definitely take the 14, but yeah, sprinkle a little. Yeah. I'm seeing 750. We either way, how many in a row have they beat Nevada?
Seven. Wow. Seven straight. By the way, how about my Kentucky Moneyline play on Saturday?
That was beautiful. Kentucky Moneyline was beautiful. We were on that.
But you were talking to Arkansas. I don't like that one, actually. I think A&M is going to fuck them up.
Yeah, they probably will. I was just saying. Seeing big Arkansas, we almost got that Moneyline Arkansas. That was suggested to us from the chat. I remember how Musselman wins those crazy games. They're getting 12, but you're right. I don't like it. I was just looking at the number, but I do like Mizzou getting 12 at home.
I do too, because they're winless in the SEC. Mm-hmm. They're gonna clip somebody we don't see coming.
Yep,
I think they can hang in that game. They've been in a lot more close games than a winless team normally would be in. Winless in the SEC, that is. Mm-hmm. I'm taking a flyer on the Mizzou Tigers.
Yes. All right.
The line has even come down a little bit overnight.
I love it.
Let's go. And then I gotta ask you about your Dukes.
I don't like.
Could the Billikens come in?
Yeah, I mean, I took
Cooper?
Yeah, they're coming into Palumbo. Palumbo Center always brings the pain, but and now it's the Cooper Fieldhouse. With Duquesne's offense, I don't like it. St. Louis is starting to score.
They got a couple guys that were injured.
Yeah, I took the 9 points. I didn't sprinkle it, but I can see them winning that game. I like St. Louis a lot.
Getting Sincere Parker back, and also getting the forward Bradley as a Wiro. They're playing better. Those are good players. I don't know that they're fully playing better because Travis Ford and. But I mean, I will take a little sprinkle on the plus 9.5 and plus 340 on the money line. You know, I don't think many other shows are calling for a potential money line on a team that's 1-8 on the road. Let's go. Billikens.
Let me toss. To
what's that?
Go ahead.
Yeah.
No, go ahead.
I was going to say, shout out to Huey Newton. I think Utah State takes down the Aztecs today Logan.
I do too. I like Utah State there too. Matter of fact, my small fave, that's got a reverse line movement. And I also like BYU to beat Baylor too.
I do too. That could be a little Utah two-step there.
Yes, that is a Utah two-step. That's a good money line parlay there, actually. A nice Utah two-step.
That's like
a Utah.
That.
That's your Busey. Utah, give me two.
Yeah, Utah, give me two. Look, you could do the Busey point break. Utah, give me two, or you could do the fade the national championship with Creighton and Utah State.
Yes, I like that.
I like Round that angle Robin too. Knows.
My favorite short. I was going to say my favorite short fave of the night is a MAC East matchup between Kent State and Ohio. Ohio is laying 3.5 at home. This is a team they beat on already beat on the road by 7. Why you on Ohio? Are you on Kent State here?
No, I'm on the Bobcats.
Yeah, I love the Bobcats.
Okay,
tonight.
Okay. Yeah,
I love the Bobcats. I don't not fave. I said not a pup. I mean,
oh, I'm sorry. I misread.
Yeah. No, I love Ohio in this game. I don't. I mean, I get it. Kent State having they've been playing some. They've been playing good defense recently, but they were going. You know, they went up against Buffalo and Northern Illinois and Western Michigan. I don't know these numbers. Those are they're all ranked in the high 300s. So I don't. Offensive. I'm not
you don't just walk numbers. In yeah. to Athens, Ohio, and the what is it the Convocation Center? You're not going to go into that Convocation Center and get that dub. Kent State's been iffy on the road. They're 4-5 on the road. They got some bad losses on the road.
Right.
Ohio had a lot of close losses beginning of the year. Remember they lost a couple guys over the past 2 years. Whether it was Vanderplas, whether it was Sears, I know those guys were gone for a couple. But it's good program, good culture there in Athens. I'm with you. Yeah. They're 9-3 at home. Lock it up, Bobcats, getting it done.
Lock it up. Four dead in Ohio. Lay the four with Ohio. That's what Neil Young was saying about. Even I got a 3.5.
What else? I mean, I also took a shot on Texas Tech -5.
Okay.
Maybe 5.5 now.
How can we talk to so. The, How about a court storming fade? NC State. Laying 6 versus Cuse after Cuse's big win at home versus the Heels.
I do actually. You know, I hate taking the Pussy Pack, but I think the Pussy Pack are gonna get it done here against the Cuse. You're on the Cuse.
No, I'm on.
You're on the pack.
I'm on the pack.
Yeah, I mean, I think if I had a lean now, there's a couple other good games here. Akron Toledo is a huge game in the MAC.
Yep.
You know, everyone on the show last night, MAC. NC Nick, Noah locked up Toledo. I locked battled them. I took the Zips. I just think the Zips are a veteran team with Ali, Enrique, Freeman, Kimball, all those vets. And Toledo, what are they, 358, sixth in defense or some shit? They're fucking terrible on defense. I think Akron's going to be able to exploit that. Zips going to win this thing on the money line. Curious what you're doing here.
I can be talked into Akron. I didn't have an opinion on this game, but I can be talked into Akron. I like what you're saying about that. They are a veteran team. I like a couple
little
of
yapper.
Games. Little yapper.
One of my favorite plays is Frank Martin's going to beat VCU. Frank Martin just lost to LaSalle, who was in dead last.
Right.
After beating the first place team, the Richmond Spiders, the game before. Mm-hmm. Now VCU comes to town. I refuse to believe that VCU... Ryan Odom's done a great job, son of Dave, and done a great job in year one. Yeah. 5-1 on the road is bullshit, though. I don't believe they're that good. This is one of my favorite plays of the night.
Yeah.
Yeah, it might be my favorite play of the night. Wow. I think UMass is going to fuck up VCU. So,
let's lock it in.
Let's go.
Let's lock it
Hit
in.
It, UMass.
Fuck yeah. Going in right now.
Get that thing in there, and then I did
what
also.
What do you think about it? Speaking of Maction? What do you think about Central Michigan at home laying the one?
You know, I actually bet Bowling Green.
Did you really?
I bet Bowling Green because Central's coming off the Western rivalry game.
Yeah,
and Bowling Green has been pretty good this year, but they got smacked the other day by Eastern Michigan randomly. So I think
they've lost 5 of 7, and the 2 wins were at home.
Well, Central's certainly playing better, but I just think you get that Western game where they throw all that fucking toilet paper in that rivalry game. I don't know. I just think it's a good spot for Bowling Green.
It is a revenge game. Central Michigan did just win in Bowling Green. It was a double overtime. It was double overtime, right?
Yeah. So I think that's the angle there. I didn't touch the Miami, Ohio, Western Michigan game. I leaned Western at home in Kalamazoo. And then, I'm on St. Mary's though. I think St. Mary's laying 7 or 7.5, I think is the right side of that battle of San Francisco. Shout out Michael Barker. I know he'll be at this game. That's one of the ones. And then I'll ask you about two more and then we'll jump into tomorrow's slate.
Okay.
Is Pitt going to win tonight?
This is a huge game for both.
Wake is undefeated at home this year. They're 13 and 0, but they're just 5-5 in their last 10. Meanwhile, Pitt has won 5 straight and they've been road warriors, man. They won at Duke. They won at the Pussy Pack. They won
I'm not ready to go against Pitt. I'll take the 6 with Pitt.
I'll take the 6 with Pitt too. I think I'm going to end up pulling. I haven't bet that yet, but I think I'm going to.
Maryland, coming off a little. See, we had a thing with Maryland. We couldn't. It was too quick of the news of Lefty going to get Tragic Magic when their first game versus Illinois the other day. So now maybe we can parlay and roll over a little Tragic Magic. I'm always willing to fade Wisconsin. I think that team is fucking garbage.
I think they are too. I think Wisconsin, but that's not even a crazy money line play. Now I think Wisconsin probably wins the game.
Yeah, I mean
I think it's worth a sprinkle because I do believe Maryland's got some athletes that Wisconsin can pose some real problems for Wisconsin. I'll definitely take the points in the Terps.
Yeah, I'll take 7 there.
Yeah, let's go on that. And there's another Ball State Northern Illinois game. I got nothing on that. I took Ball State. I don't feel good about it.
I tell you what, I do like the biggest spread on the board. I like Boise State to beat the living bejesus out of San Jose State tonight.
Look, I took the points, but I don't have any real conviction to my me taking the points. I thought sleepy spot. You could be 100% right there. Boise, they fucked up Fresno the other day there. They blew out Fresno and Fresno and Fresno's probably a little bit better than San Jose.
Right, and San Jose State is no Fresno.
Yeah. that's a good point. It's a good point.
I just say Boise flexes.
All right. Well, folks, get in. Listen to the old bet detective. All right.
Sniffing out those lines. I always sniff out the bad lines so no one else overdoses out there. It's a dangerous world on those streets.
Now let's get into Tuesday slate. But before we do that, I want to tell you the college basketball experience is brought to you by Game Time. Buying tickets to your favorite events shouldn't be that stressful. Game Time is the fast and easy way to buy tickets for all sports, music, comedy, and theater that is near you. With killer deals and last minute tickets and their best price guarantee, you can stop stressing over the tickets and start getting hyped for the fun you're going to be having at that very event. So what are you doing, folks? Snag the tickets without the stress with Game Time. Download the Game Time app, create an account, use a redeeming code SGPN to get $20 off your first purchase. Once again, terms apply. Redeeming code SGPN for $20 off. Download the Game Time app today. Last minute tickets, lowest price guaranteed. We're also brought to you by Underdog Fantasy. Look, Underdog Fantasy has a way to play alongside your favorite fantasy players all season long. They got NBA, they got NHL, but damn it, they got college hoops, and that's what we love here. So simply pick higher or lower on your favorite players' fantasy stats and cash in. You can win 100 times the amount of money you enter with some of their spicy plays. So what are you doing, folks? Watch along, make picks, make that extra cash on Underdog's mobile app or website, underdogfantasy.com. When you sign up with the promo code TCESGPN, and Underdog will double your first deposit up to $100. That's Underdog Fantasy, promo code TCESGPN. Also, if you sign up, take a screenshot. Find me on Twitter at DColbyD. Show me that screenshot of you signing up, and I'll send you a college basketball experience t-shirt. Brand new, perfect for March Madness. All right. Nice. All right. Let's talk about a full Wednesday slate of college hoops.
Wow, there's a lot.
There's a couple. I mean, first off, I don't know if you want to get. Are you taking Georgetown? Are you taking 10 in Georgetown?
I don't know if I could take the Georgetown. Yeah. I don't know if I could take the Georgetown. That would be a ballsy play, but that's the only side I can see now with that line being 10.
Now, I think the big one is Florida at Bama. That is a huge game in the SEC in
big
Tuscaloosa.
Number too. Seven is that?
7.5 I'm seeing. Jeez. 7.5
And I get it. Alabama's looking good. They're starting to play. I mean, they look almost better than they did last year. But Florida's good. I mean, and they're playing well. You know, but this is back-to-back road games, too. I mean, Alabama can put up numbers. So 7.5 is like 2.5 to them.
Yeah, I think I'm actually inclined to lay it with the Tide. You have
PTSD. Look at this Indiana Nebraska pick 'em line because I was all over Indiana versus Northwestern. What a fucking dud they put up there, sitting off for a week waiting on a game they needed at home. Northwestern loses their best player and they get
When are these fucking idiots gonna learn that you can't just go grab a former grad that's coaching in the NBA? Do you even coach in the NBA? Does anyone actually coach in the NBA? Is there any strategy? I guess when to call a timeout. Oh, they're on a 20-0 run. Let's call a timeout. I don't know that there's any fucking strategy. I mean, you've seen it. Remember when Georgetown went for Ewing. Oh, he's assisted with the Bobcats, Charlotte Bobcats at the time. Yeah, how'd that work out? Chris Mullen was an assistant, right? He was an assistant with the Kings, I think, Sacramento Kings.
Yeah.
How'd that work out for St. John's? Clyde Drexler. Remember when Houston hired Clyde Drexler? What, that shit was a terrible hire. And you're seeing Penny. He didn't even have any coaching experience. They're just like, yeah, sure. I think he coached high school or something.
Hey, he's a legend around. He'll get kids to come in. Great. Then he'll still run that program into the ground. My God, they need to get rid of him now.
He hired Rick Stansbury in the offseason. That was a head scratcher as an assistant. But yeah, I mean, I don't understand why they keep going for all these former players. We got a couple big ones in the ACC. Duke heads to Miami. Jimmy Larrañaga. They've been from Final Four to looking like dog shit. That's exactly what has happened with the Miami Hurricanes. Any chance? See, I think this one could be a nice dog.
Yeah, it could be a nice dog. Duke's starting to get it together a little bit though. I was on Miami. I got a lucky push, I think, when they played Carolina at home that good game. They're tough at home. So I'll take the five. What is it? 5.5 they're getting?
5.5 I think you load up on the Canes.
Yeah, I'll grab the
money
Canes
line
here,
play.
5.5 for sure. Absolutely. This
money
is,
line play.
This is a classic
for this.
Yeah. This is a classic. If you're going to take the 5.5, you have to play the money line on this game.
Yes. Yes. 100%. Providence is at Xavier playing 5. I'd normally just take the home team in this.
All right.
When those two play, I know mm-hmm. Xavier clipped them in Providence though. What were you going to say?
I was just going to say, bouncing off that, I'm looking at some of these odd lines. Like, you're looking at an Illinois Penn State 7.5, and you should think Illinois wins by double digits, but it's kind of a weird schedule spot for them on those back-to-back road games, and Penn State coming at home not looking good. I kind of think this is a sleepy trap line there, and I don't mind taking Penn State.
Yeah, no, I lean Nittany Lions. You got the Egg Bowl on the hardwood tomorrow. Remember, Ole Miss beat Mississippi State the first matchup in Oxford. This is in Stark, Vegas. Mississippi State's laying 6, though.
Tension's always high there. Yeah, I don't know about that.
I would take the points, but yeah. But yeah, both teams really good defensively. Colorado State in the pit at New Mexico. That's a smash spot. New Mexico just got drilled at San Diego State.
Mm-hmm.
New Mexico is going to fuck up Colorado State tomorrow.
And New Mexico played well that game, by the way. They did get drilled. Yeah. They wound up losing by 13, but they played well. They were competitive pretty much with 5 minutes to go. They were inside the number the entire time. And then San Diego State pulled away. But yeah, I agree with you. This is a smash play of New Mexico and Colorado State on the road. Who is fading fast? Colorado State, by the way.
Oh yeah. I mean, I guess they're probably the more desperate team in this spot. But
yeah,
curious. Air Force went to Vegas a couple weeks ago and just absolutely pissed on the face of UNLV and anyone that bet on UNLV. Probably one of the most shocking outcomes this season.
UNLV, their football program coming off a season long face pissing of us, and now their hoop teams going against Air Force.
Dude,
up style. These guys are just unzipping and unloading on us.
Dude, Air Force is not a good team. All right. They went into Vegas and won 90-58 on January 23rd.
That was called right here on the Weekend Bomb Edition, by the way. I called that money line.
That is one of the craziest. That
was a schedule spot.
I didn't think they would win like that.
Bet detective sniffed that one out and said, "Whoa, whoa, whoa, boys! This line's got some fentanyl in it. Don't keep stay away."
You must be tight to that program. How the fuck did you know that was gonna happen? Now UNLV is 5-2 on the road though. They're 5-2 on the road this year. They've been better on the road than they have been at home. At home, they're losing the Air Force, they're losing the Southern. UNLV is coming off the Nevada loss. They're laying 6 in Colorado Springs. I personally think we should put our entire savings, our 401k, on the Runnin Rebs, right? Am I crazy?
Yeah.
Do you got some intel? Are they going to sweep?
This is not a sweep. This is a great revenge spot. Great number we're getting here. I like a New Mexico UNLV parlay actually. Here,
love it. Little mountainous parlay.
Yeah, a little mountainous parlay. Now, what do you think about coming off your great prediction of Kentucky money line when we knew those Auburn frauds were going to take one down at home? They go to LSU, who is terrible. It's a bad schedule spot. But I was encouraged by Kentucky for the first time this year playing what's it called? Defense. You know, they tried doing that and it worked out for them. If they can continue that, I mean, LSU was just bad, but you're right. This is a sneaky spot for them.
I mean, I think Kentucky's a lot better than LSU, but am I terrified when no one wins at the jungle? So if you win at the jungle, I imagine you're having a lot of fun. Terrified. I think Kentucky's a better team. I'm actually going to take LSU in the points just because of the spot. The spot is perfect for LSU.
It really is a good spot.
Nebraska, Indiana. I don't have a strong conviction. I lean. Indiana,
I don't like to get like to get emotional, but I'm done with Indiana for now. Indiana too soon. Don't look. I don't even want to look at you right now until that. You know, I'll talk to you come conference tournament time. But I don't even want to look at you in your dumbass pinstripe pants.
Furman is at Sanford. Huge game in the SoCon. Two top. This is a great game. It's like two of the better teams in the SoCon, and the SoCon always delivers. Man, you get these great games in the SoCon.
Always delivers.
What is this? What is this fucking line? Where am I drawing a blank on this thing? Because there's that. I mean, the SoCon's giving us some classics tomorrow. They got Western Carolina Greensboro. That's a good game. Eileen Greensboro laying the 5. They're also giving us, a nice little fun with VMI East Tennessee State. That's not very fun. I'm being sarcastic. The Citadel Mercer, but where the fuck is Wofford Chattanooga is actually not bad in the SoCon.
What are you looking for, Furman?
Yeah, you see that?
Yeah, I'm seeing Sanford 8.5.
Furman did beat him though on January 24th by 10.
Mm-hmm.
Furman's, Sanford's 15-0 at home this year. 15-0 at home this year.
Speaking of which, Gophers with another cover on the other night. They are now
22-3
against the spread this year.
How the fuck 22 is this and possible? 3. Something is what?
I know. Insane.
I lean Furman in the points though.
I do too. I think and Alfred put it in there. Sanford sputtering a little bit as Alfred 44 points out in the chat. I did not know that. 15-0 at home, though. That's pretty. Jesus Christ.
Yeah.
I definitely think it's 16-0. Revenge spot is too. I like that. I can get behind this. I
want to talk about a couple others before we get out of here. But before that, I want to tell you that the College Basketball Experience is brought to you by Hall of Fame Bets. Win bigger by betting smarter this NBA season with Hall of Fame Bets, the sports betting analytics platform for parlays, player props, and game lines. Research every NBA and soccer bet with historical stats and data. Stop betting in the dark and join over 30,000 different users researching with Hall of Fame Bets to craft more intelligent, data-driven parlays. Download the Hall of Fame Bets app or visit hofbets.com. Use that promo code SGPN to get 50% off your first month today. Start researching, start winning with Hall of Fame Bets. All right. I mean, the chat brings up a couple. There's a couple other ones here that are interesting to me. The Missouri Valley has a couple games. you look and see Belmont at Drake. Drake is currently tied for first place. Belmont 16-11. They're still in the mix a little bit. Fifth place currently in the Valley. The Valley is always so good. Belmont beat them by 22 on January 7th. Now this is in Des Moines.
It's in Des Moines. It's a big number. Was it 9.5 I'm looking at?
Yeah, and I think we should lay it. Because when you beat them by that much points,
right?
And Drake's 14-0 at home. I think we should lay it. I think they're gonna fuck up Belmont. I think they're gonna win by 18.
You're right. That like is that. That's a secret. That's a different kind of revenge. That's when you get embarrassed like that.
I love that Drake side of things.
All right, I'll take out a second mortgage since I already have the other one on UNLV.
Let's load up. All right, yeah. call up an old uncle. Ask for any money you can find.
Can I get an advance on that, Will? I know you're about to die. Your health ain't looking too good. Can I get a little advance on that?
Let me tell you about Drake. Right? Murray State is at Southern Illinois. The Salukis.
Love Salukis.
Murray State's getting 3.5. I personally think the Salukis.
Yeah,
I like a couple favorites in the Valley there. I'm going to lay the 3.5.
I'll lay that short number, no problem. I love the Salukis at home always.
Oklahoma State, they played well at Oklahoma, almost won it on the money line.
How they blow that game? They were winning an entire game. Jesus.
But then they took down BYU and Stillwater. They're kind of finding their stride here. They headed to Cincinnati. They're catching 10 at Cincinnati. What? I will take the points with the Cowboys. You?
Yeah, I'm not laying 10 with Cincinnati ever. Anyway. I mean, listen, I know Cincinnati is a good team, and they've been been on the wrong side of a lot of results. But the way Oklahoma State's playing, give me the 10 points. I would never feel confident laying 10 with Cincinnati.
Yeah, and then Charlotte's at Memphis. What in the fuck is happening to Memphis?
I mean, Penny's got to go. This is a disaster. Yeah. That was embarrassing against a fucking undermanned SMU team the other night. I mean, Jesus.
I mean, Charlotte is coming in. Charlotte's playing for first place. Oh, man, I don't like this game, though, because I just feel like Memphis has so much better of a roster than Charlotte.
They do have a good roster, and it's getting embarrassing. And anytime you got a team with their backs against the wall like that, where they're getting embarrassed.
I'm seeing 5.5 now for Charlotte. The line to set Memphis as a 5.5-point favorite is fucking insane. Yeah, the only logic I can see is they're 10-2 at home.
Right.
All right.
I would, to be honest with you,
you got to take Memphis, right? You got to take Memphis
It's Memphis or nothing. Although, I mean, how confident can you be even playing in Memphis right now? I mean, they've been bad for the last month and a half. It's not like this is like a recent couple games. This has been going on for a while. So why would we think that would change? Although I do sometimes there is back against the wall spot. This is it.
I got one that might be the best play of the whole fucking week.
Oh, let's hear it. Give it to me.
You ever watch Marshall play basketball at home?
Is it an enjoyable experience?
They can light it up at home. Now on the road, they are fucking horrible. Yeah. All right. Like horrible. In fact, 4-10 on the road this year. JMU has won 6 straight and they're going into Huntington. Marshall's lost 3 straight. I see them getting 7.5. There's no money line out yet. I tend to think Marshall is live. They just light it up at home. I just feel like that's a very hard place to win. It's a very hard place to win. And you look, even the times they've lost at home, they would have covered some of these spreads here that they lost to ODU by 7 exactly.
Yeah.
I think they're getting up. They know that they lost to South Alabama by 6. Mm-hmm. They just play better at home. I think they're live. I am going to sprinkle Marshall and I'm going to ride that on the money line. That
place
over the past few years has been a hornet's nest. If you come in as the 1 seed or the 2 seed in the Sun Belt, you normally lose in that fucking stadium. So
let's go there. 7.5 at home.
Let's go.
I think that whole game is going to be a shootout. What's that total? 154, I'm saying, something like that.
Yeah. Give me that over.
I think it flies over that number.
Give me that over all day here. Notre Dame and Louisville's at a pick. Don't even watch that game.
No. Notre Dame. What a, I mean, good Lord. You, it's time to check yourself when you're a pick'em versus Louisville.
I think Georgia's at Vanderbilt. That's actually, what's the spread? Because
Vanderbilt, that's one the Jesus beat out of them.
That what they beat A&M at home though the last time they played. No,
they did
beat
A&M in that buzzer beater, but then they just lost. But was it
by 1,000 to Tennessee? Yeah.
Tennessee. I kind of liked Vandy there too. Plus the 19 at a hook.
What about South Florida coming off that huge win, going down to San Antonio, take on the Roadrunners? Roadrunners are getting 7.5. Any chance you might buy a little stock?
I'll take a little nibble with that. Sure.
Yeah, I think I might too.
That's a good spot. You parlay that money line with Marshall money line. Now we're talking. Now we'll buy that third house so we can mortgage after the next one.
There we go. And hold on, I gotta check on a Navy spread. You see Navy Loyola Maryland out there? I don't think they released this thing yet. The main reason why I expect this to be a short line, but Loyola Maryland has been a fucking darling of mine this year. They have made me more money. What did Ric Flair say? But yeah, they've just made me a shit ton of money. And it's not out yet. They hold back these Patriot League lines. I'm telling you, there's a real thing on these Patriot League money lines. Another one to watch that there's no line on yet.
You've been preaching these Patriot League money lines.
Oh yeah. They've been hitting all day. Asheville heads to Longwood. That's one. I expect Asheville to be a decent sized favorite. I think Longwood could get him. There's no line out yet. But I'm just saying, I think that's one. Watch out for the Lancers at home. And that's pretty much, you got anything else on the board? I think that's pretty much it.
I mean, there's a lot to get in there. I don't know.
I love the chat. We have Dust Up in the chat. Always fun. When people are name calling other people, it's great.
A little incarnate word, a little fighting in the handshake line in the chat. It looks like as you're coming after each other for names. Keep it cool, boys. Come on.
Lane Elliott says Navy's -1.5. Well, then you got another dog there. That's a true yapper. That's a fucking.
That's a little nipper. Yeah.
That is the smallest chihuahua. Like that's an anemic chihuahua. But I still like it. Navy looks like ass this year. All right, folks. Well, look, we'll be back later tonight talking about all the games, what happened today. And obviously tomorrow's loaded card. We'll touch more on, and make sure you get over there to Twitter or X and give CJ Sullivan a follow, the Bet Detective. He is available on Twitter at CJ Sullivan _. And check out the Bottom Line Bombs podcast. The C Block. Look at that right there. YouTube.com/thecollegeexperience. You see that art right there. You gotta check out the Bottom Line Bombs podcast. It is fucking fantastic. So do that. I'm on Twitter at DColbyD. The College Basketball Experience is on Twitter at TCE on SGPN. And check out the Sports Gambling Podcast. And as we break down college basketball and college baseball, check out the College Baseball Experience. Noah Beanick doing great work. I got the fucking UNC Greensboro is a big dog right now against Wake Forest. They're up 4-1 in the seventh. And what's up?
Bank that.
Yes, let's go. And check out the College Football Experience. They're doing a Win Totals episode tomorrow. Me and the other guys. Power Five win totals are out for next season. So we're going to key in on that. We already did a schedule breakdown on the Big 12, ACC, SEC, Big 10. So go check out those episodes. Good.
Save some for the UFL for crying out loud.
Yeah. So we have the UFL gambling podcast, not the USFL because they got rid of the S. But the UFL gambling podcast is coming very soon here in March. Me, CJ Sullivan, and J Mark, host of the Old Fashioned Football Podcast, which you should check out as well. God damn it! I feel like it was like a '90s rap song at the end where you just shout out everything you know, like everyone in your crew.
Right. Like, shout out all the crew. I like when they would do the festivals. They would shout out the sponsors too. For they'd be like, "E40 is going to be there. Sam Adams is going to be there."
Shout out to Mountain Dew.
Mountain Dew will be there. Missy Elliott. Yo-Yo will be there.
Folks, until next time, this is the College Basketball Experience. You better start thinking about yours. And we are out of here. Run, shoot.